great thrill for Michael Atherton, captaining his country in a test match at Lord's. He had an excellent test at Trent Bridge, so too did Graham Gooch, and in fact the whole of the England team. They outplayed New Zealand and thoroughly deserved their innings victory. It was their second successive test win in England. Here at Lord's, the England captain should be absolutely delighted to be one up after one.
Three test match series, you've got to make a good start, which we did at Trent Bridge. And then the pressure's always on the other side, because to drag it back in a three-match series is not that easy. So the pressure's on New Zealand to drag it back for this game, but also we feel if we can play to the level that we played at Trent Bridge, it'd be nice to wrap it up here.
Premature celebrations, perhaps, but it might just be the aftermath from Nottingham. Welcome to Lord's. It's a terrific social occasion here, as well as a wonderful cricketing occasion. The social occasion means that the atmosphere on the first morning of a test match is quite sensational, something you don't find on any other cricket ground in the world. The cricketing occasion, absolutely first class. And the teams for today's game, the second test match in the series, are England. They have one change to the Trent Bridge side. That's Paul Taylor comes in for Devon Malcolm. Not very happy Devon Malcolm, it turned out. And Pocock is in for Hartland. Pringle is back in the side. Danny Morrison, unfortunately, is back in New Zealand. Geoffrey Boycott now with his pitch report.
Lovely sunny day and a nice day for batting. We have a look at this pitch, it's an absolute beauty. No real bounce, look at this, I'm throwing a very firm hard ball into the pitch. It's not really bouncing at all. I think the batsman will want to be on the front foot. I pop the key in, it's just touching the surface. You never get them solid and really hard at Lord's, but you get them firm. And if we look down the pitch on a length, you'll see how dry it is. Look at the cracks appearing already, but they're solid, firm cracks. I don't think the edges are going to go. And look at the grass here. It's a nice root growth everywhere. You see here? I think it's going to be a belter of a batting pitch. Probably the ball won't come on too easily. You'll need to play off the front foot. But I think anybody who loses the toss will be really upset at this.
Sounds as though there'll be plenty of runs there for the team winning the toss and batting. In this case, it's New Zealand. Ken Rutherford called correctly, and he'll be very, very happy about that. We join play now in the opening over of the day. No runs are on the board. Angus Fraser is the bowler, and Brian Young is taking a strike.
Well, that's the right line. Brian Young just thinking about playing at that.
Well, this is as perfect a line and length as you could get with the new ball. If you bowl a lot of those, then sooner or later you're going to get somebody to nick one. It's a difficult period for an opening batsman. You know, it's a lovely sunny day for batting, lovely pitch. And he's just trying to feel his way, get used to the pitch and the bowling in the first half an hour, 40 minutes.
Well, that's it. That is the wicket that England will be very glad to see arriving so early. Brian Young shuffling across in front of his stumps. A little tentative so early in the day. And Angus Fraser, on his home ground here at Lord's for Middlesex, strikes the first blow for England.
Yes, Davey was spot on. A little tentative here, staying on the back foot. A lovely line and length by Angus Fraser. Talked about it, the ball before.
So Ken Rutherford, as New Zealand's captain, finds himself walking out to the crease substantially earlier than he would have hoped. Philip de Freitas will open the bowling now from the nursery end. And what a good start that was. Right on line, just the right movement, perfect line, a little bit of movement away from the bat.
This was a short ball that I don't think he seemed to pick that up very well. He's not particularly quick, Angus Fraser. I think it's just a little bit of nervousness from the batsman.
Beautifully bowled. He really did nip away pretty sharply as he pitched. There's no way Pocock was going to get a bat on that one.
Yes, he wasn't able to get really forward to this. It was a shuffling around the crease, and I think if anybody had nicked this, like a leg break going down the hill, they'd have thought they were in magnificent form, because not too many batsmen my career would have nicked that. A magnificent delivery. He's bowling quite a bit of zip, is Philip de Freitas. Well, nothing wrong with a shot from Ken Rutherford, just a beautifully bowled delivery. Look at that. Angles in from the bowler's delivery to off stump, cuts away like a leg break. Anything you bowl away from that nursery end is helped by the slope on his screen, goes left to right, but it's going to cut away even more. Just run down the slope. A lot of bounce in that ball, hardly carrying.
Well, what can you say? Ken Rutherford will just be smiling to himself there, thinking, well, at least as long as I don't nick them, I can have another go, I'll still be here. But Philip de Freitas bowling absolutely beautifully. The first shot of any power of the day comes away very quickly down that slope.
Well, it's good cricket here. Philip de Freitas bowling that foolish length. So it's good bowling. And the batsman will be pleased, though. He got it in the middle, but it kind of squirted out square.
Well bowled by Fraser. This is his home ground. And he's certainly been getting a little bit of bounce there. He's a tall player. Delivers with a high action. Be a considerable relief, I would think.
So Pocock is now off the mark. He's been there for just over 40 minutes. And of course the outfield's very fast here.
Four runs, wherever it came off. And happily for the New Zealand captain, he got a bit of bat on it. Overpitched and wide of off stump. I think it'll take Paul Taylor a little time to settle in this comeback match. Through, but the ball is really overpitched and there's no third man back there. That's quite a decision for a captain. If the bowler is swinging the ball into the batsman, then the slips need to be there, but you see, it just requires a little bit of follow through. Oops, is in the air, but a bounce there. Well, Pocock goes, a great forward, by no means a half volley. They just gave the ball that room to bounce if it would bounce, and so it did. Caught by Smith at City Point.
Well, it's certainly good bowling, but I think he's a little bit unlucky as well. And it's very good bowling to make the ball go straight on. A little bit of bounce, and it was a simple catch then for Silly Midoff.
This is Martin Crowe. Warm applause for Martin Crowe, recognised of course as one of the finest batsmen ever produced by New Zealand. 39-2.
Yes, not a good delivery from Peter Sutts. Bowled a bit flatter. Tried to hurry it through, bowled it too short. And they gave Ken Rutherford just the chance he was looking for to find his spot on the offside. so close. Just a miscue, a little bit of a chip shot. Just dropping short of silly mid-on. Nicely flighted again, and Ken Rutherford not there. That was the problem there. He didn't quite make it to the pitch of the ball. And just managed to stop himself pushing through the ball enough, hard enough to get it to Craig White at silly mid-on. That was a fine shot. Nicely timed by Ken Rutherford. Perfectly placed into that gap. Rolls away down the slope, as ever at Lord's, very quickly.
Of course, Peter Sutch is trying to spin the ball up the slope too, isn't he? So if he gets a little bit short and wide, the ball is just really going to go straight on. There's not going to be too much there for him at all.
That's four more. Very firmly struck by Ken Rutherford this time. There's no man out in the deep.
But I'll take the runs again, David. It's nice to see that scoreboard ticking over. Bit of a contradiction, really, but Ken Rutherford's quite happy to play a shot if the ball's there to be hit. And you can only admire that approach.
Michael Parkinson and Melvin Bragg just having a quiet chat. Should go on for a while. And a fine shot. Perfect example of the hook shot from Martin Crowe. Seemed to have all the time in the world to play that shot. Played it well, kept it down, hit it away very firmly behind square.
Two more runs added to take it along to 2 for 65, New Zealand at lunch on the opening day. Young Naught, that'll be a disappointment for him. Pocock 10, took him a long time to make the 10. Rutherford has batted well for his 37, and Crowe unbeaten on 9. The bowling figures for England, very, very impressive. Fraser, 7 overs, 3 maidens, 1 for 5. De Freitas, none for 15. Taylor, none for 22. And Sutch, 4 overs, 2 maidens, 1 for 12, with White bowling 2 overs and Gooch 1. So a good morning's cricket, a tough morning's cricket, appreciated by all the crowd. At Lord's, they always take the opportunity to meet up with old friends. It's part of the social occasion I mentioned earlier, the opportunity for people to prepare lunch, to have a drink, and to reflect on what the players might have done in the opening 2 hours of play. We join play after lunch now in the second over. Two runs have been added. Philip De Freitas is the bowler. Ken Rutherford, the New Zealand skipper, is taking strike.
Well, those are like leg breaks. You could say that Ken Rutherford shouldn't be playing at those, but it does go a long way. It surprises even the keeper. Such a lot of bounce and movement from nowhere. Probably had a very good lunch, as Ken Rutherford. He's not settled down. Got to get his concentration together, just hang in there.
Got him. Beautifully bowled. That's a good over from Philip De Freitas. Not just because he took a wicket. The wicket may actually have come from the previous delivery. The one that bounced and moved away. And Ken Rutherford, well, he'd be very close to distraught there. Caught by Stewart off De Freitas for 37. That is good bowling. Batsman needed to play at it. Very well done. Stephen Fleming is the new batsman, 67 for 3. Crowe is 11. That's very well played. Nice way to get off the mark for Stephen Fleming. Dashing player, very strong on the onside. Idea, but not going to let Fleming get away from him. He's a very powerful young player. It's not quite the spot to bother him.
Well, the trap would set, but the batsman saw it and avoided it with a beautiful pull shot. They had Robin Smith out on the boundary, I think it was.
Shot.
Most of his runs come on the onside and drives through extra cover.
Shot. Very firmly struck away by Martin Crowe. Absolute control in the shot too.
Well, Crowe has been watching the ball. He's let a few balls go outside the off stump. And that one just gave him a bit too much room or width, really. Certainly well played.
Well, nicely timed. There's absolutely no effort in the shot at all. Just to the left of Graham Gooch at cover. A despairing dive. Wasn't good enough to stop the ball going for four. New Zealand bring the 100 up. 100 for three now. Really was a lovely piece of timing from Stephen Fleming. Just dropped the bat on it. Dead square of the wicket, and Graham Gooch completely deceived by the pace of the ball. And that's what I call a sprawl. Partnership developing now between these two, Fleming and Crowe. New Zealand reached the 100 mark. That's pushed away nicely through that gap, that extra cover. And Gooch might yet get a lunge in for it. Ah, that's the footwork you learn at West Ham.
Yeah, but he hasn't got an arm though, has he? And so they've run four.
And on the end of it, the batsmen have time to run four, so a lot of effort there. And yet the scoreboard will still show the same result. Managed to get it straight onto Stephen Fleming's bat, and a nice well pitched up delivery for the left handed batsman, enough to see him take four more runs. Edged away but edged down and into the gap, so a triumph, a moral triumph for Angus Fraser. Indecisive shot from Stephen Fleming, but four runs to the batsman.
Yeah, Stephen Fleming just shuffling across the crease. He never really went forward or back. He was obviously unsure on how to play the length of this ball. He's been very decisive in his shot playing, even though he's played a miss once or twice. But there, he was very indecisive. Another short ball from Craig White. Seen already the few over the ball at Trent Bridge, and today is this long sort of action. A bit new to seam bowling, but every now and again he surprises the batsman with an absolute beauty. Melvin Bragg on the left, David Mellor on the right.
Well, that should do Martin Crowe a bit of good. Not much good for Craig White, but that's well up, and he's a master of that stroke. Quite a powerful flick through mid-wicket.
Classic spin.
It was as well played as anyone could ask. Two men posted out there behind square leg, one just behind the line of square, the other in the normal, much more orthodox position of long leg. And that was a no ball into the bargain.
Now, Stephen Fleming very happy to play shots, and that's certainly well played. Kept it down too. I think when you pull the ball in front of square, then you're seeing it pretty well, and the pitch is perhaps a lot more placid now than at any other stage of the day. Of course, the ball's getting softer, the bowler's a bit tireder, but there's runs to be scored.
Well, the shout is there, and he's given. Fleming looked up very quickly and then saw the dreaded raised finger from umpire Clues at the nursery end. He's gone now for 41.
And he doesn't look very happy about this, Fleming. And I don't think he hit it, so I think he's been given out LBW. I don't think he's been given out caught behind.
I'm sure he's been given out LBW. And it looked to me as though it would have hit middle. That's what I'd mark down as a good decision from umpire Clues. Stephen Fleming, very, very promising player. LBW to Fraser for 41. Looked good once again, and this is the way he was dismissed.
There's Angus Fraser. He's the man that's done the damage. And that's going to hit middle. That's a very good decision, our LBW. Shane Thompson, who's been a little bit out of sorts with the bat on this tour.
Good stroke from the hobbling crow.
Beautifully played.
Not the sort of over you look forward to the night before while you're trying to get to sleep.
It's certainly not a nice way to start when you come back to the bowling crease, a couple of no balls and then driven through the offside. In fact, it wasn't necessarily a bad delivery. It's very well played by Martin Crowe. I think you ought to give the batsman some credit here.
Loose delivery, too short from Peter Such, and Thompson gave it the treatment. That's a splendid recovery from the New Zealanders, 160 for 4, 19 extras in that total, and most of those are no balls. Rutherford out, unfortunately, from New Zealand's point of view, immediately after lunch, but a staunch innings from Fleming. Looks a very good player, made 41, made them in excellent style, and Martin Crowe is still there on 48. One run has been added after tea when we join play. It's the fifth ball. Martin Crowe is on 48 and Taylor is the bowler.
Oh, another fine shot.
There's been absolutely no effort at all, and that takes Martin Crowe past the 50 mark. 52 not out now, Martin Crowe, and a lovely shot to pass that little landmark with. Clues taking plenty of time to think about it. No luck for Paul Taylor. 174 for 4.
Well, I would think that Shane Thompson's mouth there was a bit dry. This ball probably pitching outside leg stump and then going on to hit the stump, but that's not out.
He's picked that up a long, long way. Really is an effortless shot for 6. And using the line, the spin, the slope, using everything just to help that ball on its way. Picked it up very cleanly indeed.
Well, I rather think that Martin Crowe's had this in mind off Peter Such for probably an over or so. Probably been waiting for the right ball. Same again.
Well, it's like London buses, Jeffrey, isn't it? Suddenly two come along at the same time.
Yes, he's good at that shot, though. We've seen off the seamers, anything that's drifting down leg and middle, he plays it well off his hip. It's a pick-up shot, And you see here, this one's drifting down. It's going to miss. Look where the wicketkeeper is. It's going to miss leg stump by a long way. So it's a free hit for somebody who likes to hit it in that area. And he's very good at that, is Martin Crowe.
Oh, that's a good shot. Pleasant footwork to the pitch of the ball, and then that very elegant levering of the ball over mid-on for four. And it's a 50 partnership. Lovely shot. Six runs again to Martin Crowe. Well, it's been given four. Quite a shout in the crowd. Convinced that it was six. Which is a six that's given by Steve Bucknell, the umpire. So there's a little dispute there as to whether Martin Crowe had hit a six or a four. It's his second six.
Raymond's new sunglasses, are they? He's supposed to get a sponsored pair sooner or later, isn't he?
Four runs. There's no third man down there. Oh, well bowled. My word, that was right through him there. I think Shane Thompson will find his footwork less than satisfactory, less than crisp, but 2-22 for 4.
Yes, well, the bowler will feel as though he's done everything there to bring about the dismissal of the batsman. So the batsman takes, well, a little bit of luck.
Oh, well, that went rather on the low side, I think. Vince may have gone under the bat. Let's just take a look at that. Thompson was certainly giving it all he could. Oh, lovely shot. Showed a nice piece of character there. Shane Thompson gets beaten by De Freitas, but is then straight out of the traps, onto the front foot, and cracking the ball through the covers.
Craig White so far has bowled 10 overs, 1 maiden, no wicket for 45. A little bit of a tester for him today. He's expected to play a full part with the ball. And here he is now with 10.1 overs gone and 49 runs taken from him.
Yes, Craig White here with a very short, wide ball, easy to hit and put away.
Very good stroke off the back foot again. The thing that strikes me, Geoffrey, about what the selectors intend to do is that, first of all, they haven't done it yet. They haven't played their two spinners so far. And secondly, that they need a bowling all-rounder rather than a batting all-rounder, which is what Craig White is.
Absolutely, Richie. I felt today that they should have played the extra spinner. And I'm not too sure that Craig White is the answer, because I believe he's a batsman bowler.
Shot. That's good timing. It's so good that the man at mid-off didn't even bother to chase. Knew that it was going to be picked up by the spectator.
Well, it was a perfect shot. Foot to the ball, nice straight bat. Timing was good and the placement was excellent.
Not many have done that today, but needs a good bowler to extract that sort of life.
Well, it's a strange delivery, surprised everybody.
didn't play it very well, the batsman. It just bounced a bit.
Oh, it's a beautiful stroke. A classic stroke. Takes him to within one of a century.
Yes, another of those strong areas from Martin Crowe. Back cutting it, past gully, behind point. He really does let the ball come on. Hit it away beautifully. That and the pick-up off his legs are his favourite areas.
And that's it. To Martin Crowe, a very, very good innings. Nice standing ovation for him. And the twist of the knee there may have caused him some pain. He'll soon disappear. 101 not out. Fielder to worry too much about that. Good stroke and a wonderful way to bring up a half century at Lord's.
Top shot, this ball from Angus Fraser wasn't that short at all, short of a length, but he picked it up so quickly, outside off stump, good feet movement, got into position early, and then used that pick-up flick shot that he's so good at. 5,000 test match runs, still going at a very healthy average, 47.
Great stuff. 281 for four.
Michael Parkinson in the middle. He's enjoying himself, and so is Richard Branson. More so than Michael Parkinson.
A 1-2 mid-on brings up the 150 partnership. Martin Crowe and Shane Thompson. And that partnership has come at a good rate. Very good batting from these two, just 130 minutes. That's four. Not a good delivery from Angus Fraser. Very unlike him, just straight down the leg side like that.
Either he's very tired or he's very disappointed with the delivery. Perhaps it's a combination of both because he's had to bowl quite a few overs today and he's a big man.
...300 up for New Zealand. And when the first wicket fell with not a run on the board this morning at the end of the first over, there might have been some trepidation in that dressing room that things weren't going to go their way. But 300, a good score there.
That's something for the total at least. Thompson will have to wait to see what Steve Buckner has to say about it. He's saying that It was runs off the edge, so it's just a question now of where it went. Did it go past the keeper or past the slip?
Had that been earlier in the day, perhaps the wicketkeeper might have caught that.
11 more runs added to take it along to 316 for four. A wonderful performance from the New Zealanders. A splendid fight back after they lost those three wickets early on in the innings. Martin Crowe, 133, masterly knock from him. Stephen Fleming, 41, and Shane Thompson, 68. And a terrific effort from them as well, two good young players. 27 extras, most of them no balls again, as is shown with the England bowling figures. 17 no balls in that lot. A wicket there for De Freitas, two to Fraser, and one to Peter Such. Here now, with his ideas on the day's play, is Geoffrey Boycott.
Well, it was a day of two parts. New Zealand struggled to take advantage of a very good batting pitch. Some accurate bowling by England kept them pinned down, and right up to tee, 160 for four, it could have gone anyway for either side. But after tee, that was when the game changed. Martin Crowe took charge. He belted the England bowlers all around the park. He got rid of Peter Such, hitting him out of the attack, and he dominated the whole proceedings, and he played like the class batsman he is, the class batsman that's been searching for form all through this tour, but today he found it and he pleased everybody. He was ably supported by Shane Thompson, and now New Zealand are in an excellent position at the end of today. England's bowling, no penetration, that was the problem. Steady stuff from Philip De Freitas and Angus Fraser, but all in all, they needed somebody with a lot of pace, a lot of aggression, somebody to rattle the batsman. I'm afraid England are looking down the barrel tomorrow of a very big total if Martin Crowe still stays there.
Thanks, Geoffrey. Geoffrey Boycott with his ideas on what happened on the first day of this match between England and New Zealand. The second day comes up here at Lord's. BBC One, 10:55 a.m. We're on the air, and it's been splendid entertainment on the first day. We hope the second is just as good. We leave you now with three cricketers, two of them very young, very inexperienced, Fleming and Thompson from New Zealand, and the other one, a master. A wonderful innings today from Martin Crowe.